sorrows through in liberating strife. Who more than self their country love, and mercy more than life. America, America, may God thy glory find, till all success be nobleness, and every gain divine. Oh, beautiful for patriotry, that sees beyond the years, thy alabaster cities gleam, on him thy human tears. America, America, God shed
thank God that there are still folks in this country that can get excited about celebrating our great country, the United States of America. And you know, I noticed that it's the Christians, it's the believers that know beyond the shadow of a doubt that this country was founded on the principles of God that still hold and are hanging in there for the United States of America as we keep it under God, under God, under God. Hallelujah. You may be seated this morning. It's a delight to have you here with us in our church service. On once every 7 years, we get to celebrate the 4th of July on Sunday. And so it is a great honor to be able to do that today. I'm thankful to my cousin Ron and his wife Barb as they have brought Roger and Kay Thurber with us here this morning. And our Jerry Lonnen and Andrew McKee are here with us this morning. God bless you. I'm so thankful that we have an opportunity in the United States of America to gather together in the name of Jesus without fear of repercussion and stand for Jesus, worship him in spirit and in truth, and nobody's knocking at that door trying to keep us from doing it. So let us not take those freedoms for granted and worship God in spirit and in truth today, because that's what he's worthy of. Amen? If you will refer to your bulletin very quickly this morning, next Sunday opens our 2021 Kids Crusade. There's a flyer in there. Make yourself available of that. The Johnson family are going to be back with us. They are the same family that were with us last year. In the middle of the COVID crisis, we had one of the most fantastic Kids Crusade that we have ever had. And I think 2021 is going to be even better. So get your kids to Kids Crusade. Get your kids inviting kids to Kids Crusade. Ages 4 through 11, it's going to be fantastic. Also, our worship in the park is back. Hallelujah. July 18th at 10 a.m. at the Orleans Marine Park, where we've had it before. We're combining together with the Lord's House, and Pastor Eddie English is going to be bringing the word, and he's also going to be bringing the chicken. And so that's awesome. You come, bring a dish to pass. We'll supply the plates and the cups and all and the beverages, but you bring a dish to pass, and it's just going to be a great day to worship God in the park. Hallelujah.
You know, these new mics that we have, they tell the sound guy when the battery is going bad. So that's a good thing, right? That's a good thing. This morning, if you'll take out our memory verse, take out your memory verse, and I suspect Jesse will have it on the screen as well. but it's very appropriate for this day. And I want you to say it with me. It comes from Galatians chapter 5, verse 1. And it says, and read it with me, "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage." One more time, let's read it again. "Stand fast, therefore, in the liberty by which Christ has made us free, and do not be entangled again with the yoke of bondage." You know, Jesus wants to set us free, and he wants us to stay free. He doesn't want us running back to the bondage whereby we were delivered. He's provided for that freedom, and I'm so grateful to him. Memorize the scripture, put it in your memory bank, so when it's available to you at any time, the Holy Ghost puts it upon you in your time of need. We're going to open up in a word of prayer tonight, this morning. And then that's going to be followed by the singing of the national anthem, after which we will be saying the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. So let us bow our hearts in prayer. Almighty God, Creator of all things, we come humbly before the throne of grace this morning, our hearts full because of the great sacrifice your Son Jesus gave, that we might be set free today of the penalty of sin and death. We are so thankful, Jesus, that you paid the price, a price that we owed but we could not pay, that through your grace and your mercy you've extended it to all of your creation. Father, we thank you for life. We thank you for liberty. We thank you that we can pursue happiness in the United States of America. God, we thank you that nothing misses your eyes, that you know the details of our life, and that you care and that you love us. But Father, we're grateful for that. Father, I'm thankful that as we have gathered today in your name, Jesus, that you will receive our praise and our worship, our exaltation, that it might be pleasing in your eyes, that it might come from our hearts, that we might not do anything to be seen of men, but Lord Jesus, that you might be high, that you might be lifted up, that you might be exalted this morning. Holy Spirit, have your way in this place, I pray, in Jesus' name, that you might be glorified. And oh God, we know that there are many needs represented here, and you care about each one. So we acknowledge you in all of our situations. We put our trust in you, oh God, and we know that you will direct our path. You're going to heal today. You're going to deliver today. You're going to set free those that are in bondage today. Lord God, I thank you that you're a God that can do anything, that there's nothing impossible with you. Now, oh God, we stand in victory because we take dominion over the powers of the adversary, the devil, who is like a roaring lion roaming around seeking whom he may devour. Lord Jesus, there will be no devouring today by the devil because of you, Jesus, because of the victory that you won on the cross of Calvary. Hallelujah. So, devil be gone. Jesus be exalted. We give you praise and honor and glory in your great name. Amen and amen. Now, Caitlin is going to come and lead us in the national anthem.
Would you please stand?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through through the perilous fight, or the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave? O'er the land of the free and the home of the brave. Amen.
And now if we could stay standing and do the pledge to the flag. We have a flag over here. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic Oh, don't you sit down yet. Now we're about to worship. Oh, you're not. My bad. We have something cooler.
You may be seated. But I have a wonderful, awesome privilege this morning to dedicate dear Remy Lynn Fulman to the Lord this morning. So I'd like Remy to bring her parents and her grandparents and anybody that would stand with Remy this morning in dedication to come to the platform.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. All right. Remy was born on December 24th, 2019. And her parents are Jesse and Kristen Fulman, our beloved youth leaders here at Oak Orchard Assembly of God. And so they're continuing to build the youth group through Remy. Amen. That's the way I think the church should be built. Hallelujah. And I want to let you in on a little secret. That not only Remy is here, but in a few months, there's going to be another little Fulman. Woo! You know, there is authority in Scripture for dedicating children. And it comes from Jesus himself. Jesus in Mark chapter 9, he sat down and he called his 12 disciples over to him. And then he said, anyone who wants to be first must take last place and be the servant of everyone else. Then he put a little child like Remy among them. And taking the child up in his arms, he said to them, anyone who welcomes a little child like this on my behalf welcomes me, and anyone who welcomes me welcomes my Father who sent me. And then in Mark chapter 10, it said, then they brought little children to him that he might touch them. But the disciples rebuked those who brought them, saying, you know, children, they are to be seen, not heard. Get the children away. Jesus is an important person. He doesn't care about little children. Well, Jesus took umbrage with that. But when Jesus saw it, he was greatly, greatly displeased, the Bible said, and he said to them, let the little children come to me, and do not forbid them, for of such is the kingdom of God. Assuredly, I say to you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter in. And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. And I'm going to attempt to do that with little Remy right now. To the parents, do you today recognize this child as a gift of God and give heartfelt thanks for God's blessing? If so, say we do. Do you now dedicate Remy to the Lord, who gave her all to you, surrendering all worldly claims upon her life in the hope that she will belong wholly to God? And do you pledge as parents that with God's fatherly help, you will bring up Remy in the discipline and instruction of the Lord, making every reasonable effort with patience and love to build the Word of God, the character of Christ, and the joy of the Lord into her life? And do you promise to provide through God's blessing for the physical, emotional, intellectual and spiritual needs of Remy, looking to your own Heavenly Father for the wisdom, love, and strength to serve Remy and not to use her? And now do you promise God helping you to make it your regular prayer that by God's grace, Remy will come to trust in Jesus Christ alone for the forgiveness of her sins and for the fulfillment of all his promises to little Remy, even eternal life? And in this faith, follow Jesus as Lord and obey his teachings.
You're just being awesome.
This little girl, as you can see from the support that she has on this platform this morning, and I know that this congregation as well supports little Remy and her growth from this point to knowing Jesus as her Lord and Savior. We all make that vow together. If you say so, say amen. And now, Remy Lynn Fullman, together with your parents, this congregation who love you dearly, and this people here who care about the outcome of your faith, I dedicate you to God, surrendering together with them all worldly claims upon your life in the hope that you will belong wholly to God forever. I pray, Lord God, the blessing on the house, on the Fullman household, and may they ever know your love for Remy and the new little one coming as well, Lord Jesus. Bless this pregnancy. I pray that it would go to completion successfully and bring another little Fullman into this world. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
All right, now you can stand back up.
Walk in your freedom, walk in your
where the Spirit of the Lord is. For freedom you set us free. It is for freedom you set us free.
There is no shame. thank you for your faithfulness, O God. You're worthy to be praised, Jesus. We bless your name. We magnify your name. We bless the name of Jesus. You've been so faithful, God.
Hallelujah. I just want to cut in here for a moment as we're worshiping God. Declaring His amazing grace always brings a tear to my eye when I think about what Jesus did for me. What a sinner that I am. You may be seated. Yvonne is just in, or I'm sorry, Denise was just impressed that God would have her share a testimony of what God did this past Tuesday. Denise?
You know, because of God's amazing grace, I'm standing before you this morning. Last Tuesday, we had a fire at my work. Praise God, it was a small fire. It happened in our QA room in my department. And my coworker, a fellow coworker and I, he gives me a ride home at night, and he's also a Christian. And we're talking about it. And I go, you know, Raphael, there's chemicals in that room. In the beginning of that room, well, the fire started in the back. And God saw fit not to have that fire reach those chemicals, because there would have been a lot of lives lost that day. And I just want to give glory.
Give Him glory.
And praise to Jesus.
Yes, give Him glory. Hallelujah.
And that God will continue to work in my life and show people the love of Jesus at work.
Amen.
And I praise Him and I thank Him for His amazing grace and His mercy.
Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise the Lord. You know, it's so important. That's what puts the devil on the run in our life, is when we give God the glory for all of the situations and the details in our life. That is the Proverbs 3, 5, and 6 scripture. It says, trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not on your own understanding, but in all of your ways, in all of your dealings, acknowledge that God is there, that He has control in those situations. And then He promises to guide and direct your path as He's guided and directed your path as well. And this is a calling for every single believer, every single Christian. Every single citizen of the United States of America that's a believer in Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior, they are called to acknowledge God in all of the aspects of their life, and He will direct their path. Hallelujah. God is good. Thank you, Denise, for that testimony this morning.
Let's proclaim now that He is the great I Am, as well as everything else that He is. Amen. Let's stand and worship together. Let's worship.
I want to be close to your side. So heaven is real, and death is a lie, yes. I want to hear voices of angels above, singing as one. There is no power in hell or any who can stand. ravens run and flee. At the mention of your name, King of Majesty, there is no power in hell or any who can stand before the power and the presence of the great I Am.
You're the great I Am. The great I Am.
The great I Am. The great I Am. The great I Am. Hallelujah.
Holy, holy, God Almighty, the great I Am,
who is worthy, none beside thee, God Almighty, the great I Am. Hallelujah. Holy, holy, God Almighty, the great I Am,
who is worthy, none beside thee, God Almighty, the great I Am.
It's the great I Am. Give you praise this morning, Lord God. You are worthy to be praised, Jesus. King of kings and Lord of lords, we worship you today. We exalt your name, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you for our freedom. Thank you.
Bless your holy name, Lord God.
Thank you for your mercy, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
You're worthy.
Yes.
We exalt you.
The great I Am. There is none beside him. He's the beginning and the end, the first and the last, the Alpha and Omega. Hallelujah. That's the God that we serve. You may be seated this morning. As the children come and join me, and we pray over the retiring offering this morning, I have a special request that you would add to your offering this morning. One of our own here at Oak Orchard, and they will remain nameless to not have any embarrassment, but were criminally and viciously scammed out of $1,800, and this person is on a limited income. I'm telling you, they're out there, and they mean harm on the people of this country, and they prey on people with good hearts and want to do what is right. And this was just an evil, evil act. But I'm calling upon this household of faith to give in an offering this morning to help this person recover from this terrible, terrible act. So in your retiring offering this morning, if you would just, all of the monies that are not designated tithes or offerings, the loose money will go to this cause. If you're going to make out a check, make a check out to Oak Orchard Assembly of God and just put in the memo there a special offering, and it'll get to the right place. If you want to go on Oak Orchard Assembly of God, .com and go to Tithely to give. You can give online as well. Just designate it in the other column and it'll get to the right place as well. But I'm just so thankful for this body of Christ that steps up every time when there is a need. So if you would be generous in this need this morning. And look at all these beautiful kids this morning. Now I've had a request and I'm going to honor it. And what song would you like to sing this morning?
Bubbling.
She wants to sing It's Bubbling, Ricky. You know, it's bubbling, it's bubbling, it's bubbling in my soul. What's bubbling in your soul? It's the Spirit of God. It's the Spirit of Jesus. The fact that she wants to sing It's Bubbling, hallelujah. I said, we cannot deny that child that opportunity to do that. So you probably know it too. I know Sid Cree knows this song, It's Bubbling, okay? All right, he's going to sing it with us. You guys know it? And you know the actions as well, right? It's bubbling, it's bubbling, it's bubbling in my soul. It's singing and shouting since Jesus made me whole. Folks don't understand it. I can't keep it quiet. It's bubbling day and night. It's bubbling, it's bubbling, it's bubbling in my soul. It's singing and shouting since Jesus made me whole. Folks don't understand it. I can't keep it quiet. Why? Cause it's bubbling day and night. Yeah! Amen. Amen. Let's pray. Jesus, we thank you that you are bubbling up in our hearts as a wellspring of living water flowing out of us. Father, I thank you for these children. I pray that you would bless them, be with them as they go to children's church. Anoint the teachers, oh God, that they may know who you are in a real and mighty way. Lord God, bless our offering this morning as we give cheerfully as unto you, God, recognizing that we are mere stewards of all that you have given to us. Bless it and honor it, and we honor you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. God bless you guys. Bubble on out of here. All right, we did it. Hallelujah. For my message this morning, we're going to sing one more song. It's entitled, My Country, 'Tis of Thee. And certainly, without God, our country would be nothing. We could be just a third world country. But because of God, we have been blessed and we have been set apart to be a light in the world. Sing it with me this morning, if you would stand as we sing. Liberty and freedom. What a wonderful thing. What a wonderful thing. And I know that we all enjoy our freedom and our liberty. This morning, I want to share part two of our two-part series on freedom and liberty. And of course, we know the day that we celebrate today, July 4th, in 1776, the Declaration of Independence was shared. And I'm just going to read the first part of it to you to put in context my message of liberty and freedom this morning. The unanimous declaration of the 13 United States of America, when in the course of human events it becomes necessary for one people to dissolve the political bands which have connected them with another, and to assume among the powers of the earth the separate and equal station to which the laws of nature and of nature's God entitle them. A decent respect to the opinions of mankind requires that they should declare the causes which impel them to this separation. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, that among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Our country had gotten to a point under the oppressive tyranny of King George that they came to a decision that they had to make whether or not the rights that had been given them by God Almighty to freedom were going to be maintained in this new land, this new country. These 13 states had to get together, and they debated this issue, realizing that a declaration of independence in the eyes of King George would be a treasonous document, and that their lives could be on the line, and that they could lose their lives. It would have been, I suppose, very easy for them to say that, you know, it's just not worth it. Freedom is just not worth it. There's never been a country in all of the world that has been governed by the people. And this is what is being proposed here, that this government would be a republic, that it would be governed by the people. And if you govern it by the people, that means you have to take into consideration everybody's worldview and everybody's opinion on things. And how do you do that? Well, you do that through representative government, our Senate and our Congress, our House of Representatives, the president, the judicial branch, all of them, checks and balances to make sure that the people's voice, the free people's voice, are heard. But you know, freedom has never, ever been free. Freedom isn't free. That's like, that's kind of an oxymoron. Yeah, freedom is not free. People pay a price for freedom. People paid the price, shed blood for our freedoms in the United States of America. Why is this precious commodity that God has given to us called freedom, called liberty? How precious is it? Does it mean a lot to you and me this morning? You know, I don't think we can fully understand how much it means until it is started to be taken away. When it starts to be infringed upon, when your voice begins to be muzzled, when you are under executive order taking your freedoms and rights away, then we stand up and we take notice and say, you know, I really enjoyed those freedoms, and I think I've probably taken those freedoms for granted. We should no longer take our freedoms for granted in the United States of America. Hallelujah. But who can we rely on to stand up for our freedoms in this country? Well, I contend to you this morning, those that, like our founding fathers, had a relationship with God that knew that if Providence didn't take its role in our country, that our country wouldn't be a country. It wouldn't be a representative republic. We wouldn't have our freedoms. They understood, those that were looking death in the eye, that if God isn't part of it, it will surely, surely fail. They understood that. That's what this country was built and founded upon. That's why those words were so initially put into the Declaration of Independence, that these freedoms that we're fighting for were not given by any man, but they were given by God Himself. And so now we have to look at what is freedom in the eyes of God. What is the freedom that He has given to us as believers? And if you'll turn in your Bibles to John chapter 8. And here we see Jesus, after the woman had been caught in adultery, and He dealt with that situation, sending her away, her sins forgiven, and no one condemned her, and Jesus didn't condemn her either. She says, I'm going to set you free from the bondage that you were under through your sin. I set you free this morning. He continued to teach the people, and told them that where He was going, this is Jesus now, He said, you can't come. But He continued to encourage them to see where the freedom will come through Jesus Christ. And we pick it up on verse 31. It says, then Jesus said to those Jews who believed Him, the Jews that believed Him, He said, if you remain in My word, then you are truly My disciples. This word that we're memorizing, the word of God, if we remain in that, if we live in that, that is proof of us following and believing in Jesus Christ. If you reject the word, if you have no time for the word, if you don't put the word in your heart, you are telling God that I am not your disciple, I am not your follower, and I don't believe in you. So this is an introspection as He's talking to those Jews that believed in Him. And they answered Him, we are Abraham's seed and have never been in bondage to anyone. So Jesus, why do you say you shall be set free? And Jesus answered them, truly, truly, I say to you, whoever commits sin is a slave of sin. Now, I think they could understand this because since the beginning of time with Adam and Eve, and whoever was free in this world, it was Adam and Eve. They had free reign of the garden. They could do whatever they wanted, but there was just one thing they couldn't do. And what couldn't they do? Eat of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. Just one thing. It's not like they were destitute and they were going hungry all of the time, and that's why that tree looked good to eat. They had everything. The climate was perfect. It was paradise. You are free to do whatever you want except one thing. Don't eat of that tree. But what happened? The devil stepped in. Satan never wants you to live in freedom. He always wants you to live in bondage. Can you get that this morning? So God is a God of freedom. The devil is a liar and wants to put you in bondage. And that's exactly what happened when Eve was beguiled by the serpent. He said, you'll not surely die. She ate of the fruit. She gave to her husband. He ate. You know the rest of the story. They were cast out of the garden. Sin comes into the world. We're all born into sin because of that act. And we're no better than Adam and Eve. Because think about it. The freedoms that we have, I think we take for granted too. And we say, well, we can play around with that freedom. And it'll always be there. We can
do things even beyond our freedoms. We can toy and play with sin. We're free in the grace of Jesus Christ. Don't be deceived. When I say don't be deceived, I'm talking about one deceiver, and that's the devil. The devil wants to deceive, and he deceives very cunningly. He is not one that is outright in his deceit, but he's one that takes things and makes truth, and he twists truth so that you'll be deceived by it. My good friend that was scammed on the phone heard words, good words. We want to protect your money. We want to protect your assets. If you'll give us this money when you go to court for these charges that you're up against, we'll protect this money for you. When the court case is over, then you'll have it back again. Oh, that sounds like this person is out for my welfare. They want me to be free from the penalty that is unjustly coming against me, and my money's going to be there when it's all over. It was all a pack of terrible, terrible lies, sounding good, using all of the right nomenclature and saying that they're on the phone with the courts at the same time and saying if you don't do exactly what we tell you to do and don't tell anybody about it, that we will come out and arrest you if you don't do it within 45 minutes. Just trying to instill fear. But under the guise of this is all for your welfare. The devil, you will not surely die, but you'll know good and evil like God knows. And God doesn't want you to do that, but it's a really good thing. The devil's a liar. But Jesus is truth. Say that with me. Jesus is truth. The devil's a liar, but Jesus is truth. And what does the truth do for us? The truth will set you free. So we need to know what that truth is. We need to know what that truth is. So verse 34, it says, truly, truly, and these are the words I say to you, whoever commits sin is a slave to sin. Now, a slave does not remain in the house forever, but a son remains forever. A slave is transient, and they can't go wherever they want to go. They're not free to do that. But now a son in a household has authority to dictate what the slave does. And so here, as we come to that scripture, therefore, if the son, now in my Bible, and I don't know about if yours, son is capitalized. And when Daryl Lynn put the scripture out there on the sign, I said, I want you to change son, and I want you to put Jesus out there so everybody knows when they go by that it is not the son of somebody else, but Jesus is the son, capital S here. If the son sets you free, the analogy here is, the son in the household that has control over the slaves, if he says you're free, then you are free indeed. You're absolutely free. If Jesus says you're free indeed. And what are you free of? Remember, the devil is the one that wants to bind you, put you in bondage. He wants to put you in bondage to your actions. He wants to put you in bondage to your sins. He wants to put you in bondage to your inadequacies. He wants to put you in bondage to all of the things that you have done in your past. He wants to bring them up. He wants to throw them in your face. He wants you to feel unworthy. But Jesus, hallelujah, went to the cross for that very same purpose, to set us free from the penalty of sin and death. And what is the penalty of sin and death? It's separation from God for eternity. Without Jesus, we go to hell and live in eternal torment. Forever, our soul lives on, either in heaven or in hell. Jesus said, I want to set you free from the penalty that you do owe. I want to set you free. And the way that I'm going to set you free, and we're going to partake of communion in just a moment, is that I am going to pay the price for your freedom. I am going to go to the cross, and I am going to give my life. No man's going to take. I'm going to give my life. So to pay the penalty that you owe, he shed his blood on the cross of Calvary. And because of that, that shedding of blood means that our sins can be remitted. For without the shedding of blood, there is no remission of sin. Jesus fulfilled the law in all of its glory when he went to the cross. And by the way, did Jesus have a choice? He did have a choice, and proof of that is when he was praying to his Father in the Garden of Gethsemane. If this cup should pass from me, let it be so, O God, but no, not my will, Jesus said to his Father in heaven, but thy will be done. He did have a will. He could have said no, but he was here to do and be obedient to Almighty God. He said, my people are in desperate need of freeing from the bondage of sin. And I love them so much. Not just white people, not just black people, not just red people, not just yellow people, not just green people, and not just purple people. But all people. Every single life matters to God, and he loves every single one of us. He's no respecter of persons. When he went to that cross, he went to the cross for you and me and everybody. You might not have the same grace and mercy that Jesus has. I thank God that Jesus has a lot more grace and mercy than I have. But he's called us to try to get a little closer to him every day. Show a little bit of mercy. Show a little bit of grace. Because do you know how much grace and mercy God has poured out upon us? Hallelujah. He paid the price that we might be set free. Hallelujah. From sin. He also paid the price that we might be set free from the law. In Romans 8, 1, it says, there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free from the law of sin and death. For what the law could not do, in that it was weakened by the flesh, we can't follow the law. God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh. And concerning sin, he condemned sin in the flesh in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fulfilled in us who walk not according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. Christian, we are to walk according to the Spirit and not according to the flesh. What is this flesh that we walk in? How carnal it can be. Even those of us that believe in Jesus Christ have been saved for many, many years. Doesn't sometime the carnality of our flesh get the better of us? God knew that. So when he went to the cross, the price that he paid was for the sins past, present, and future. He does not need to go to the cross another time. Don't put him on the cross again. Jesus went once and for all for the sins of the world. Can I get a hallelujah? Why? Because he loves you so much, he wants you to live in freedom. For where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. And when you come to know Jesus Christ, who dwells within our heart, it is the Spirit of God. If you're living in bondage today to anything in your life, God wants you to be free from that bondage. He wants you to be free in the Spirit of Almighty God. Can I get an amen? And you know that Spirit that bears witness with my spirit that I am a child of God is what frees my spirit. Because when I know that I'm a child of the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, what can man do to me? My Father is the creator of the universe. Can you believe it this morning? Really? Butch stamp, sometimes it's hard for me. I confess, I have to say, God, help my unbelief that you would have so much mercy and grace on such a worm as I. Such a worm as I. But he does, and we believe it by faith, because as we sang it this morning, great is thy faithfulness. Even when we're not faithful, my God is faithful. Hallelujah. So we're set free from the law. Jesus came to fulfill the law. We have one law under Jesus. Love the Lord thy God with all thy mind, soul, strength. And the second is like unto love thy neighbor as thyself. Love Jesus. Love Jesus. It's just like, don't eat of that one tree. You get everything else. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you. Seek Jesus first. He will set you free from the bondages in this life. Hallelujah. But you don't know my situation, Pastor. I don't need to know your situation, because where the bondage really falls in my life is not something behind bars, but it's a bondage that I fall into in my heart. I can be bound by unforgiveness. I can be bound by bitterness. I can be bound by broken relationships. I can be bound by depression. God wants to set us free from that, and he will, because we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. Nothing is impossible with God. It seems impossible. It may seem impossible to now, but put your trust in God. He will turn all things together for good to those that love him and are called according to his purposes. Can I get an amen? Love Jesus. There it is again. Love Jesus. And he reveals his truth, which sets us free by the Spirit of God, who leads us into all truth. And here's the truth, hallelujah, it's been given to us in written form. And if you can read this morning, you can know the truth. And if you know the truth will set you free. And when the Son sets you free, you are free indeed. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. This morning, if you have your elements for communion. By the way, this will be the last time that we will be using these particular elements. We've used up our supply, thank God. And the elements are just as valid as if it was the old way. But we need to move on to the way that we used to do it. And so this will also be the last Sunday that we will be taking a retiring offering. We're going to pass the plate again. And we're going to take communion, and we're going to serve, our elders will serve communion as befitting. The song that Ricky is playing is that Jesus paid it all. Not part, but all. There's no role that we have to play in this great sacrifice that Jesus did. And he says in God's word, in the 11th chapter of 1 Corinthians, as Paul is admonishing the group of people that were not following in the Lord's Supper in a proper manner, and he was encouraging them to do it right. And so before we partake of communion this morning, let's make sure that we are in right position with Jesus Christ, recognizing his shed blood. So let's just take a moment, get everything else out of your mind, focus in on Jesus, humble yourself before him. Ask him to forgive you of your sin, to humble you, to be your Lord every moment of every day. Jesus, Jesus. I have received of the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "Take and eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." So as we take this emblem of Christ's broken body, which was beaten, torn, ripped, crown of thorns placed upon his head, beard plucked out. Ridicule came, voices shouted. Some even called him the devil. Some were shouting, "Crucify him." Oh God, we are thankful and we remember what you went through, the pain and anguish that you went through because of your great love for us. Let us partake of this emblem of Christ's body. In the same manner, Jesus took the cup after he had supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant, hallelujah, in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes." Thank you for this emblem of your shed blood on the cross of Calvary. Thank you for your cleansing power. Thank you for forgiveness, O God. Thank you, Lord God, that this plan was in place from the foundation of the world. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you love us so much that you gave your life. We remember today by partaking of this emblem of your shed blood. Let us partake together. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, we bless you, O Lord. We thank you, O Lord. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's just sing this song this morning. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but he washes white as snow. Jesus paid it all. Well, Jesus paid it all to him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, he washes white as snow. Well, Jesus paid it all to him I owe. A crimson stain, he washes white as snow. Hallelujah, hallelujah. If any of you are in bondage this morning to anything, I want to pray for you this morning. If you could just be so bold as to take a step to this altar this morning, I just want to anoint you with oil and believe for your deliverance today from whatever bondage you might be in. Just know that the blood of Jesus wants to set you free today. If there is any that would come to this altar for prayer this morning, we will wait just a moment. Come on down, and we want to pray for you this morning. We want to pray for your freedom. We want you to be set free from the bondages of sin. If you need a prayer for healing, we want to pray for that this morning. If you want the Spirit to come into your life and set you free and to lead you into all truth, I want to pray for you this morning. Hallelujah. We'll take a moment this morning. Praise you, Jesus. Glory to God. If that's you this morning, just come down to this altar. We'll anoint you with oil and believe for you today. Thank you. Yes, come on down. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus wants to set you free this morning. Jesus wants to break the chains that bind us this morning. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Bless your name. Anyone else? Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. We're going to take a moment to anoint these with oil and pray for them. And would you just take a few moments and pray in your seats for these that have come forward this morning. Hallelujah. It's not late. God wants to do a work this morning. Let's believe together. Thank you. praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I've just said a number of prayers to be released from depression. So I'd just like to, in closing this morning, all of us bow our heads, because the circumstances in our world are very conducive to depression. And when we forget who we are in Jesus Christ, we can succumb to that. Let's pray together. Father God, I pray that as we know and we have the head knowledge that you are the God that sets us free, that you are the God that loves us, that we are your children. We know that. We see that in your word. By faith, we receive it today. And I pray, Lord God, that the circumstances of our life or the circumstances in the world, in our country, that those circumstances, that we would know that you have it all in your able hands, that we don't have to fix it, but God, you have it in your hands. All we have to do is pray, and all we have to do is believe, and all we have to do is trust in you. So help our unbelief. Help us to truly believe in you for all areas of our life. I pray that we would trust in you each day for all of the situations of our life, that we would acknowledge you. Oh God, direct our path. I pray for the spirit of heaviness, hallelujah, to be lifted. I pray when those feelings of depression come over us that we would give you praise and give you glory for who you are, so that that spirit of heaviness and depression would be lifted as we see how great and mighty and awesome you are and how much you love us. Oh, hallelujah. May we live in the spirit and not in the flesh. And we ask you, oh God, to go with us. Keep us united under the cross of Jesus Christ. May your spirit, Lord, dwell within us in a real and rich way. May your glory be shown forth in our lives, oh God. May we give you the glory in all the situations of our life, in everything we give thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. So go with us. Help us to be encouraged today and to live in victory. For there's victory in Jesus, because you paid the price that we could not pay. Thank you, Jesus. We love you. Go with us in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Have a wonderful Independence Day. Until we meet again.